Hello, crew, and any other music lovers watching this video. This week's prompt is our thoughts on the change in technology from CDs to iPods and how they've changed society. So this is really a discussion on the evolution of music and how it's changed society as well. So I'm going to begin by going into the background of music and how it's actually changed listening-wise. This discussion begins with the invention of the phonograph by Thomas Edison in 1877. This is the weird box with the iconic horn on the top. This made it possible for music lovers to listen to their songs wherever they were. This was altered and modified to eventually become the classic vinyl that we all think of. Music radio was later introduced in the early 1900s. This was interestingly rejected originally by music listeners because they thought talk radio should more be a discussion between two people rather than standardizing it for music listening and just public use. Now, in 1958, the tape or the cassette was invented. This allowed for standard home listening of music. And along with the invention of the cassette or tape, obviously came the Walkman. And actually, in 1983, the cassettes outsold vinyl for the first time in history. Now we enter the digital age with the compact disc or CD. The invention of this came in 1980, with the popularity exploding in the later 80s. The first MP3s came in 1983, invented by an electrical engineering PhD student, and it was actually part of his thesis to modernize the digital era of music listening. Now, MP3 development and its history is a long and complicated story, but all you need to know is that its popularity expanded immensely in the 90s. The market destroyer of MP3s came in 2001 with the Apple iPod. With the iPod came iTunes, which is often renowned as the world's best and easiest to use jukebox software for music. Now that we understand the history behind music evolution coming from all the way from the phonograph to the iPod slash other mobile listening devices today, I'm gonna get into my thoughts on the whole technology transition. So as each technology piece grew in popularity, so did its capacity for music listening. So I've actually noticed a big change in how much music I listen to, depending on each device that I actually own. I'm a child of the digital age, so clearly I'm a little bit biased. I'm a huge fan of the iPod and other mobile listening devices. It's a lot easier for me. It's something that I really love now. I've owned everything from a Walkman for CDs, I had a little MP3, I had an iPod, and now I actually listen to music on my phone, which is an Android, not an iPhone at all. Way back when I had my Walkman for my CD player, my music library was limited to how many songs were actually on that CD. So generally, if you remember, that would range from about 12 to 20 songs. So that's all you could listen to in one sitting or one walking, as you're, I guess, what you're supposed to be doing with your Walkman. And that would only be if you're actually listening to the entire CD. And then beyond that, how many CDs you owned is really all the music that you owned in general. Then came me to owning my MP3. So my MP3 probably was around like a gigabyte of data or something like that. So I did have a limited amount of space to be listening to songs as well. At the time I was like, wow, I can listen to more than 20 songs and I could skip through them and stuff like that. It was crazy to me then. But now, really, when I compare it to the mobile device that I listen to on, it's a really small amount of music. Now, the music that I listen to is all stored within, I use Google Play Music, stored within that listening motive, and it's unlimited to me. I don't need to buy these songs, I can just stream them. It's not limited to my phone capacity or anything like that. It's all stored in some cloud wherever Google keeps all of it. So really, it's a giant difference to me. I'm sure many of you can relate to these depressing times of when you completely filled up your MP3 with as many songs as you could have. Even on the beginning iPods, I filled it up all the way up, probably like 1,500 songs or something like that. I couldn't have any more. I also shared an iTunes account with my sister, so yeah, being a little sister, my songs got deleted first. So that was a really hard time for me. But now, as I was saying, I don't have any limitation to how much music I'm able to listen to. What I think about when I think about the transition of CDs to iPods to all of that stuff is just the immense capacity of music that you can listen to at any time that you want. Those are my thoughts. Thanks for watching this week, guys. I can't wait to watch your videos about what you think about the transition of CDs to iPods. Bye.